Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now we'll take the second problem. Okay, earlier problem we have seen all the elements in the first column of the Roth's array are positive, hence the system is stable. In the second problem, if you see, another example is given: 3s4 plus 10s3 plus 5s2 plus 5s+2. Once again, it is a fourth order system, and these are its coefficients. So as I said, see all the terms are present or not first. Fourth, cube, square, 1, 0. All 5 terms are present. In between, all of the signs are positive. That means system may be stable. This is our first conclusion. After that, we have to arrange in a Roth's array. So s to the power 4th term is there. So that is 3. I will write 3 here. I will leave 10 and write next 5. And there should be sufficient gap should be written here, because you require space to do the calculation in subsequent rows. So that's why it is written at a distance. I will write 3 here, leave 10. I will write 5 here, leave 5, last 2. So the first row is 3, 5, 2. Then the second row, remaining elements. That is s to the power 3 term, that is 10. I will leave this, write next, that is 5. Leave this, next term is 0 only. So I will not write 0. Whether you write 0 or not, it is assumed to be 0 only. Next, to calculate the third row. So what he has done, you just see here. This is not the third row, this is second row repeated. So he has taken 5 common. He has taken. So instead of 10, you will get 2. Instead of 5, you will get 1. See, why you are taking common is not mandatory. So if you take a common, the numbers without a calculator also. Otherwise, the numbers will become huge, like this 135. If here also, if you would have taken 8 common, then this calculation would have been done very easily without using calculator. But if you don't do that, the numbers will become huge, and hence the calculator is required. So hence I will take the common 5. I will take common in the second row. So 10 divided by 5 is 2. 5 divided by 5 is 1. I will write that. Now this row is redundant row now. Don't consider that row. So the next row, that is s square row, s4 is there, s3 is we have already written. Now s square, s to the power 1, s to the power 0. These are the 3 calculations you have to do. So this 2 into 5, 10, minus 3 into 1, 3. 2 into 5, minus 3 into 1. This into this, minus this into this. Always, you cannot do this into this first and this into this next. There is a particular order, remember that. This multiplied by this, minus this multiplied by this. It is basically based on the determinant method. So the order is fixed. 2 into 5, 10 minus 3, that is 7, divided by first element in the second row, that is called as key element, 3.5. That is 10 minus 3 divided by 2 is 3.5. Similarly, now 2 into 2 minus 3 into 0. 2 into 2 minus 3 into 0, that is 4 divided by 2 is 2. This 2 has come from this first column element of the second row. So this is 3.5, this is 2 now. Then next row, s to the power 1th row, 3.5 into 1 minus 4. 3.5 into 1 minus 2 into 2, that is 4. So it will become minus 0.5. Minus 0.5 divided by 2. 3.5 key element divided by 3.5, that is key element. That is 0.5 divided by 3.5. So it will come as 1 by 7. Next is this one you want. This is 1 by 7 into 2 minus 3.5 divided by this. sorry 3.5 into 0. So this multiplied by this divided by this only, it will come to 2, because 1.5 divided by 3.5 into 2 minus 0 divided by this once again with minus sign. So minus in numerator also it is 0.5 into 2 is 1. 1 upon 3.5 minus, it will be in the numerator. 0.5 upon 3.5 with the minus sign in the numerator denominator. So minus minus cancels. Minus in the numerator, minus in the denominator cancels. So it will become 1 upon 3.5 divided by 0.5 upon 3.5. That is 1 upon 0.5. That is 2. So the answer is 2. So now we have to see the signs of the first column of the Roth's array. 3 is positive, 10 is positive, 2 is positive, 3.5 is positive, this is negative, this is positive. So the system, as one of the elements of the Roth's array in the first column of the Roth's array has become negative, so system is unstable. Hence the system is unstable. When this system is unstable, now you see the number of sign changes. So this is positive sign, this is positive sign, this is positive sign, this is negative sign, this is positive sign. That means up to here positive sign, here it changes to negative. So first sign change number one. Then once again from negative to positive, second sign change. So there are two sign changes. Hence there are two roots of the characteristic equation. There are how many roots? Fourth order means four roots are there. Out of four roots, two are on the right hand side and two are on the left hand side. That means two which are on the left hand side causes the stability, whereas two on the right hand side causes instability. So as that there are two roots on the right hand side of the S plane, then system is unstable. This conclusion you have to write clearly. So this is the physical meaning of that. See, this is a mathematical tool, but finally you have to conclude the answer by the physical way, saying that if there are sign changes, the system is unstable. So first problem was stable system, second problem was unstable system. Same problem can be solved by another method. That another method is not sure shot method. Always you may get the answer by that or may not get. So this is the correct method. That another method, what he does, that it is shown here. So you have not put that. So to avoid confusion, he has not put, but you can do like that. See, what you have to do here, substitute S is equal to 1 upon Z. If you substitute S is equal to 1 upon Z, then this becomes 3 upon Z fourth, 10 upon Z cube, 5 upon Z square, 5 upon Z, 2 upon 1 is equal to 0. In the denominator, Z fourth is the common LCM. If you take that, then it becomes 2 Z fourth, 5 Z cube, 5 Z square, 10 Z plus 3. That means it will become a reciprocal of this. That means 2 will come in the first and 3 will go into the last. Then you try to solve it. Then also you should be in a position to solve that. So that is another method of doing this problem. So we'll come to what is known as a special cases. Or applications. See here, it may be noted that the order of simply compute S cube rho is the formulation of the Roth's array, which is modified by dividing it by 5 throughout. The modified S cube rho is then used to complete the process. That is, we have taken common here, 5, that he has explained. Then in the examining the first column of the Roth's array, it is found that there are two sign changes, that is 3.5 to minus 0.5 divided by 3.5 and from minus 3.5 divided by 3.5 to 2. So earlier it was positive up to here, then it has become negative, then once again it has become positive. Hence there are two poles on the right hand side of the S plane, or there are two roots because there are two sign changes. So from this you can say that the system of four roots, two are on the right hand side. Then we can come across the application of the system. Here you can see it can be solved for these examples also. Here these KV, KDs and all are coefficients only. They are written in this order. So that is, I will write to solve this. S cube term is there, S square term is there, S term is there, and S to the power 0 term is there. Now these, all the signs between them are positive. That means this KV and KD should be positive only. So instead of number, it is written in the form of KV and KD. So the first row, highest power of S, that is S cube 1. Leave this, write next, that is KV into KP. Below that, this term and this term will come. That is S square term and S to the power 0 term will come. That is 1 plus KV KD and KP into KF. Then you can calculate this B2. B2 value is this into this minus this into this divided by this. So that is KV KP into 1 plus KV KD minus KP KV should be greater than, this value should be greater than 0. Why it should be greater than 0? B3 should be greater than 0, because if it is less than 0 means sign is negative, and when the sign becomes negative, the system is unstable. Then the similarly, the last row, this multiplied by this minus this multiplied by 0 divided by this, this same term will repeat here, KP KV. So one of the conditions is KP into KI should be greater than 0, and another condition is this whole condition should be greater than 0 for system to be stable, thereby which you can evaluate these values of KV, KP, KD and KI so that the system is unstable. This is how you have to do for checking the stability of the system. Another example you can see here. So here you can see, for unity negative feedback control system has a open loop transfer function consisting of two poles and two zeros with a variable gain K. The zeros are located at S is equal to minus 2 and minus 1, and the poles are located at 0.1 and 1. Using the route stability criteria, determine the value of K so that the system remains stable. So what he has given? See, as I said in the previous class last week, poles are in the denominator, zeros are in the numerator. What he says, there are two zeros at minus 1, minus 2 and minus 1. So they will appear in the numerator. So minus sign means it is S minus of minus plus. So S minus of minus plus 2, S minus of minus 1, that is plus 1. There are two zeros, S plus 1 and S plus 2. S plus 1 is here, S plus 2 is here. Gain of the system is always in the numerator, K. There are two poles at 0.1 and plus 1. 0.1 and plus 1. Plus 1 means it will become minus 1, and actually this pole is at minus 0.1, not plus 0.1. So minus of minus plus 0.1 it will become. See, S plus 0.1 and S minus 1 because it is at plus 1 here. So these signs were negative, so they have become positive. This sign is positive, this has become negative here. So when such a case is there, that means the system chances of system becoming unstable are very high. But we have to check it. It depends on the K value also. So here it is not 0.1, it is minus 0.1. Remember, minus 0.1. So here it has become plus 0.1. Now this is open loop transfer function. Now what is given for unity negative feedback? That is, unity feedback means feedback is 1. Negative means it is minus 1. So the denominator of the transfer function will become 1 plus g of s h of s. If it is positive feedback system, it will become 1 minus g of s h of s. So positive feedback system is never used. I have explained earlier, positive feedback system makes the system unstable only. So the negative feedback is one of the most commonly used feedback. So 1 plus g of s h of s, as h of s is 1, so he has neglected. So it is 1 plus g of s is equal to 0 is the characteristic equation. So take that, this is g of s, add 1 to that and simplify. Add 1 to that and equate it to 0. That means LCM will go on the right hand side of the equation, so it will vanish. So you have to, 1 plus g of s h of s means this, these two terms will come in the front. That is s plus 0.1 into s minus 1 plus k into s plus 1 into s plus 2, and the denominator is this, and equate it to 0, that you can take it on the other side, multiplied by 0 is 0 only. So this becomes a characteristic equation. This is the method to find out the characteristic equation. In previous two problems, the characteristic equation was directly given. Here the system transfer function is given, g of s, and the feedback values are given, unity feedback, negative. And so this becomes a characteristic equation. Now you simplify this characteristic equation and arrange it in a decreasing order of s. So you have to multiply s 0.1 into s minus 1. That becomes s square plus 0.1s minus s, that means 0.9s plus 0.1 into minus 1 is minus 1. So similarly, here you can s plus 2 into s plus 1, that becomes s square plus 2s plus 3s plus 2, that multiplied by k. So afterwards you arrange, take the coefficients in the highest order of s square coefficients, s to the power 1 coefficient, s to the power 0 coefficient. I will arrange. So s square will have 1 plus k as a coefficient, s will have 3k minus 0.9 as a coefficient, and s to the power 0 term has 2k minus 0.1 as coefficient. Now see, all the terms are present. Highest power is 2, 2 is there, 1 is there, 0 is there. Their coefficient 1 plus k, we don't know whether it is positive or not. So we'll take that it is assumed to be positive. So 3k plus minus 0.1 may be positive or negative. 2k minus 0.1 may be positive or negative. It depends upon value of k, and that is exactly what you are going to find. So arrange the Roth's array, s square term 1 plus k I will write, then miss this, write next 2k minus 0.1. Below that you write this s square term, and other term, only three terms are there, fourth term has to be 0. Then simplify this multiplied by this minus this multiplied by this, that is 0 divided by key element. So it will become 2k minus 1 only, because x multiplied by y minus 0 divided by y is x only. Now see this, all these elements should be positive. So when it is positive, first you check 1 plus k should be greater than 0. Positive means greater than 0. So k should be greater than minus 1. So that is the first condition. Second condition, 3k minus 0.9 should be greater than 0. 3k minus 0.9 should be greater than 0, or k should be greater than 0.3. That is the second condition. Then the third condition, 2k minus 0.1 should be greater than 0. That is, 2k should be greater than 0.1, or k should be greater than 0.05. So what does it mean? K should be greater than minus 1, k should be greater than 0.3, k should be greater than 0.05. Which one is possible? If k is greater than 0.3, everything is possible. If k is greater than 0.3 means it is greater than minus 1, it is also greater than 0.05. So we have to get the value of k should be greater than 0.3. If the value of k is greater than 0.3, the system becomes stable. If the value of k is less than 0.3, the system becomes unstable. Is it okay? This is how you have to solve. Another equation is there. The characteristic equation of the differential equation is like this. You are asking the practical example. This is the differential equation is only given. This is x double dot plus minus x dot. This one is there. So you have to take a Laplace transform. So x double dot means s square. X dot means s. And x is x. So finally, the coefficient becomes coefficient of s square is 1. Coefficient of s is k plus 2, and coefficient of s to the power 0 is 2k plus. Here it is written, that equation. S square, this one, this one. X double dot means x square, x dot means s, and x only means s to the power 0. So arrange the Roth's array. Here it is arranged. First row, s square term, 1, leave this. Next, 2k plus 5. Second row, start from the second element, minus k plus 2, including sign. See, as I said earlier, if the sign is minus, the system will be unstable. But here you don't know the value of this. This k may be negative also. So if the k is negative, this may become positive. Hence, you cannot say that system is unstable in the beginning, because you are not finding out the stability of the system alone. You are also finding out the value of the system for k, so that system becomes stable. Sometimes it will not give you feasible answer. Sometimes the any value of k system may become unstable. So that you have to find out. So arrange the Roth's array like this, then simplify this multiplied by this. Minus 0 divided by this. See, this minus sign, this numerator becomes minus, denominator is also minus. So minus of minus plus, it will become minus x into y divided by minus x is plus y only. So here we have got it. Now you evaluate that. So first one is 1, it is greater than 0, out of question. So minus k plus 2, or minus k minus 2 should be greater than 0. So this should be greater than 0, and similarly 2k plus 5 should be greater than 0. So k should be less than minus 2, and k should be greater than minus 2.5. So k should be less than, equal to limitedly stable. When it will happen? When it is limitedly stable means this element will be 0. 0 means it is neither positive nor negative. So in that case, it will become limitedly stable. So if the k is less than 2 or greater than minus 2.5, how is it possible? It is k can be less than minus 2 and greater than minus 2.5, which is not at all feasible. So k cannot be less than 2 and cannot be greater than 2.5, minus 2.5. Both are minus values. So it is not at all a feasible solution. That means for any value of k, the system is unstable. This is what is the condition. For stability, this should be, k should be less than 2, minus 2, and it should be greater than minus 2.5. If it is less than minus 2, means it will be definitely less than minus 2.5 only. So naturally, the system is unstable for all values of k. That means for any value of k, the system remains unstable. That is your answer. Is it clear? Are you following now? Answer that. What I am saying? It is very, very simple. This is the simplest chapter. This 5 or 10 mark question, I have never seen in my life anybody has done a mistake here, unless he is totally don't know anything about the subject. Because this 5 marks question students love, actually, because everybody attempts this particular question, because it is one of the most easiest. Now, in the next class, we can go for special cases. There are two special cases. That is, one of the elements in the first column of the Roth's array becomes zero. See, first column element, when it becomes zero, the next row becomes infinity, because you are dividing it by that. When you divide it by zero, anything becomes infinity. When infinity, then in the next iteration, it once again becomes anything divided by infinity is zero. Or sometimes you will get the answer zero by zero or infinity by infinity. Zero by zero is also not defined. Infinity by infinity is also not defined. So your array breaks. So your process fails here. In such cases, what has to be done? So when first column of the Roth's array becomes zero, then it is neither positive nor negative, but you cannot proceed further because you are going to divide it by that in the subsequent iterations. So it will go on becoming infinity zero, or infinity by infinity, zero by zero type of answers you go on getting. So that cannot be possible. This is the first difficulty. Second difficulty is when whole row becomes zero. When whole row becomes zero, you cannot proceed further. Then also the same problem appears. So there are two difficulties. One, first difficulty is when first column of the Roth's array becomes zero. One of the elements in the first column of the Roth's array becoming zero. For example, suppose here instead of 16, you got it as zero. Then you are here, you are dividing it by 16. That means it is infinity. Not 135, but it will become infinity. And if this becomes infinity, infinity multiplied by anything is infinity, minus zero divided by infinity, you will get the answer infinity by infinity, which is meaningless. So instead of 5, you will get infinity by infinity. So that creates a problem. So that is the first case. And in the second case, when whole row becomes zero, so this, suppose this 2 is also zero, 1 is also not there, and it is zero, then you cannot proceed further. In such cases, what has to be done? There are two methods are there. And then there is one special case, you can say, that is given only in Nagarath Gopal. That also we are going to solve. Where in that, what happens is, first one of the elements in the first column becomes zero, and subsequently when you go on solving, one row becomes zero. So you cannot once again repeat the procedure. Two cannot be combined. In one difficulty, you can take only one difficulty into account. Both the difficulties you cannot incorporate in the solution. So in the next next Wednesday, I think there is a test. So next week you don't have any classes. Reason is, you have a test on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday is a holiday. So we'll meet after 15 days only. Is it okay?